sacrificed yourself for me? I love you.
An act of true love will thaw a frozen heart.
Love will thaw.
Love will thaw a frozen heart. If something is frozen and then it thaws, that means that this thing becomes liquid as a result of warming. Here we see a beautiful scene between the two frozen sisters, Elsa and Anna. Today we'll be learning English with two songs from Frozen, released in 2013.
For the first time in forever, I'll be dancing through the night.
A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen.
In case you're new here, our method is simple. First, you will watch the scenes with subtitles. Then, you'll learn some of the most important vocabulary, grammar, and pronunciation from the scenes. Finally, you will test your listening skills by watching the scenes again without subtitles. But before we get started and do anything else, make sure you hit the subscribe button and bell down below, because every week we put out lessons like this to help you understand your favorite movies and TV series without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles. So hit the subscribe button in order not to miss a single new lesson.
It's coronation day!
The window is open, so's that door. I didn't know they did that anymore. Who knew we owned 8,000 salad plates? For years I've roamed these empty halls. Why have a ballroom with no balls? Finally, they're opening up the gates. There'll be actual real-life people. It'll be totally strange. Wow, am I so ready for this change? 'Cause for the first time,
or gassy, but I'm somewhere in that zone. 'Cause for the first time in forever, I won't be alone.
For years I've roamed these empty halls.
When you roam, you move, travel, or walk aimlessly without a clear idea of what you're gonna do or where you're gonna go. Here's an example from Frozen 2.
We need to go north, but the Earth Giants now roam the north at night.
You can leave in the morning.
Why have a ballroom with no balls?
A ball is a large, formal occasion where people usually dress nicely and dance. A ballroom is the place where balls take place or happen. We also have the ballroom dance. Ballroom dancing includes some genres, for example, the waltz, the cha-cha, the rumba, and the quick step.
Finally, they're opening up the gates.
The phrasal verb to open up is really interesting because there are two possible meanings here. The first meaning is more literal, just like it's being used in the clip here. To open up in this case means to open the lock on a door, for example. But to open up to someone means to share your ideas, your feelings, and thoughts with that person. So if I say, come on, open up to me, I'm asking you to share your thoughts and feelings with me. Tell me what's going on. Here's an example.
What's your problem?
I'm hot. That's my problem.
Knock, knock. I'm knocking on the door, big guy. Open it.
No.
Open up to me.
No.
Share with me.
No one.
There'll be actual real-life people. It'll be totally strange.
There will be. This is the full version. In the song, we hear the contracted version. There'll be.
There'll be actual real-life people. It'll be totally strange.
Also, there's another contraction here for it will be. We hear it'll be. It'll be. So this contraction of it and will sounds like it'll, it'll.
It'll be totally strange. It'll be totally strange.
But wow, am I so ready for this change. Notice that the auxiliary here, am, is being reversed. It's coming before the subject, I. Am I so ready for this change? But this is not a question. This is an exclamation. Sometimes you see that in movies and series, people reverse the order of the auxiliary and the subject, not to make a question as you would normally think, but to be more emphatic. For example, I could tell you, boy, I'm tired. That's fine, but if I reverse the order, I sound more emphatic. For example, boy, am I tired? You see? Or I could go, boy, I'm lucky. Reversing, boy, am I lucky.
For the first time in forever, I'll be dancing through the night.
Through the night is similar to during the night. But through the night has this idea of from beginning to end. Through the night, from the beginning of the night to the end of the night. I also see that a lot in songs, you know, this phrase through the night. Here are some examples.
Or gassy, but I'm somewhere in that zone.
This is a great word, elated or elated. It's really advanced. It means to be extremely happy. I'm extremely happy. I'm elated. Now, gassy, if you are gassy, you are full of gas. Your stomach is full of gas. Here, Anna is saying, I don't know if I'm elated or gassy. Gassy, maybe because she's nervous because of the ball that they are about to have. Here's an example with each one of these words. Check it out.
Oh, how elated I am to hear that.
That sucks.
I know. I'm so gassy.
'Cause for the first time in forever, I won't be alone.
If you're like most learners, then you probably get really frustrated when you learn a new word, like elated, for example. But when it's time to speak English with people, you completely forget it, right? Now, personally, I find that the best solution for this is, whenever you learn a new word or expression, to use it as soon as possible in conversation. But then, what happens? What do you do if you don't have anybody to practice speaking English with? Well, that's exactly why we created the Real Life app, which is the only place where anytime, anywhere, you can press a button and instantly connect to another English speaker in another part of the world to have a conversation and speak together. And maybe even practice all these new expressions that you're learning in today's lesson. And on the app, you can also listen to the Real Life English podcast lessons with Ethan and myself. We give you transcripts and vocabulary flashcards to help you understand and learn even more with each new episode. By the way, the app is free to download. Now, check out what one of our app users, Shirley, has to say about her experience using the app. The Real Life app is a groundbreaking app for English learners because we can practice many abilities in one place. While we are listening to a podcast, we can read following the transcript and then practice the vocabulary through flashcards. Personally, flashcards are the best thing since sliced bread. I recall words faster while I'm speaking, not to mention I have a better understanding while I'm reading, listening, and watching. On top of all that, we can sharpen our speaking skills by talking to people around the globe. It's simply fascinating. So if you want to go from feeling like a lost, insecure English learner to becoming a confident, natural English speaker just like Shirley is doing, make sure you download the Real Life English app. I'm gonna leave a link to the app here in the description of this video. You can also go to Google Play Store or Apple App Store, search for Real Life English and download the app. Remember, it's free to download and try. I'm sure you're gonna love it. Now let's get back to the lesson with Frozen.
Snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know.
Again, we have two possible meanings here for the word glow. The primary one is the one that you see here in the song. When something glows, it produces continuous light or even heat. But a second meaning, which is very interesting, is if you say that a person glows or is glowing, you mean that that person looks well because the person is healthy or happy. For example, the kids were glowing with excitement. You see? The kids were glowing with excitement. They were really happy. Very nice use of the word. Make sure you remember that.
Not a footprint to be seen.
Your footprints are the marks you leave on the ground with your foot, usually on soft surfaces such as mud or snow in this case. That reminds me of an example of the Ice Age movie. Here it is.
Ellie, look at our footprints. They're the same shape.
Well, how do I know those aren't your footprints?
A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen.
This is really cool, and it looks like I'm the queen. So, when you say it looks like, usually you are referring to something you are literally looking, all right? Imagine I look up the sky and I say, whoa, it looks like it's gonna rain. You see, I'm seeing it, I can look at it. It looks like it's gonna rain. But if you hear something, you could say it sounds like, because you are listening to it or hearing it. For example, imagine I'm talking to you right now and then my daughter, who is a baby by the way, starts crying. And then I can listen to her crying and I can say, well, my daughter's crying. It sounds like she's hungry. You see, it sounds like she's hungry. Now, if you can feel something, if you can touch it, you could say feel like. Imagine I touch the table here and I say, whoa, this table is hot. It feels like something hot or warm was on top of it just now. It feels like it, you see? Now, if you want to be more generic, if you don't want to talk about one specific sense like seeing, hearing, or touching, generically speaking, you could say seem. It seems like. So it seems like can be used in all situations, okay? It seems like it's gonna rain. It seems like she's hungry. It seems like something hot was here a while ago.
The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside.
To howl means to make a loud sound, usually a loud sound of sadness or pain. Some animals howl, for example, let's say, dogs and wolves. Oh, 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 you know? Now here in the song, we see the wind is howling. The wind is howling. This sounds more poetic, right? The wind is so strong that it's almost making the howling sound. Got it? It's poetic. Cool, right? Now to swirl means to make a quick circular movement like I'm doing right now with my finger. All right? Here's an example.
Whoops, forgot to swirl it.
Again, in the song, this sounds very figurative or even poetic. Imagine a storm swirling inside Elsa because she's conflicted, she's doubtful, she's frustrated. So it's like there's a storm swirling inside of her.
The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside.
Storm inside. Can you hear the connection here? You have the M for storm and the vowel I for inside. You can join the M with the I. So we hear stormin', stormin', min, storming side.
The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried.
This is a nice phrase. You can say heaven knows when you want to emphasize something you believe to be true and you believe it very strongly. Here's an example. Heaven knows how much I had to work to be where I am today.
Don't let them in, don't let them see.
More connected speech. Don't let them in. So don't, the T here kind of goes away. Don't let them. So the T for let also disappears. I pronounce only the T for them. Don't let them. Don't let them. But then again, remember the M and the vowel for I, we can join them. Let them in. Men. Don't let them in. Don't let them in. And then the next phrase is don't let them see. We also have the beginning there. Don't let them. Don't let them see.
Don't let them in. Don't let them see.
Another great advanced word, to conceal. That's a verb. When you conceal something, you hide. You keep it from sight. Nobody can see it. As you could see in the clip just now, after being cursed, the prince, now a beast, concealed himself in the castle. In other words, he started to hide in the castle.
Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world.
Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go.
Let it go, the famous line of the song. So, let it go. The T for let is a flat T sound. Ra ra ra. And then let it, let it. I joined that sound, da da da, with the I for it. So, let it go. And also the T for it is a stop consonant. It, it, let it, let it, let it go. That also reminds me of the famous classic song from the Beatles, Let It Be. The connection is the same. Let it go, let it be, let it.
Speaking words of wisdom, let it be.
Turn away and slam the door.
If you slam a door, you shut the door in a forceful way, in an aggressive way, and it makes that loud banging noise. Bah! Here in the context of the movie and the song, Elsa is singing about her determination to leave her hometown. So she leaves her hometown with determination, almost in a forceful way. She slams the door and never looks back.
I don't care what they're going to say.
Rage as a noun means violent, aggressive, uncontrollable anger. But it can also be a verb. If something rages, it happens in an uncontrollable way. So here, to rage on is almost like keep happening this way, because we have the phrasal verb keep on, for example. Keep on is like continue. So let the storm rage on, let the storm continue to be so uncontrolled, so violent and aggressive like that. Big storm. Awesome, now it's time for the moment of truth. Can you listen to the scenes again, in this case the songs, and understand everything without the subtitles? Let's put your listening to the test and watch everything now without subtitles. Here it goes.
The window is open, so's that door. I didn't know they did that anymore. Who knew we owned 8,000 salad plates? For years I've roamed these empty halls. Why have a ballroom with no balls? Finally, they're opening up the gates.
In another meaning of this phrasal verb, if you open up to someone, you get angry at this person, share your feelings with this person, don't talk to this person.
People, it'll be totally strange. Wow, am I so ready for this change? 'Cause for the first time in forever, there'll be music, there'll be light. For the first time in forever, I'll be dancing through the night. Don't know if I'm elated or gassy.
To be elated means to be extremely nervous, to be extremely curious, to be extremely happy.
But I'm somewhere in that zone, 'cause for the first time in forever, I won't be alone. I can't wait.
White on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know.
A synonym for conceal is hide, share, argue.
Well, now they know.
All right, now it's time for the comment of the day. And the comment of the day comes from a lesson that we did here on the channel a while ago about podcasts, learn English with podcasts. And user OZ7QG2NX1D, whoa, left us a nice comment. Here it is. Having been a subscriber to this cutting-edge channel, I must admit, this channel is hands down the best of all time. You guys have a really masterful and exceptional way of teaching English, which makes it more engaging and convenient for English learners, so that they don't have to deviate from their routine. I truly appreciate your efforts and have a good one. Thank you so much for the wonderful comment. I'm so glad to hear that you enjoyed the videos here and the channel. Keep watching the videos, it means a lot to us, all right? And now I have a challenge for you guys out there. Can you write 3 sentences with some of the words that you learned in today's lesson? And I'll go back to the lesson review and maybe pick 3 words that you liked, that you learned, create 3 sentences and post them here in the comment section below. I'm curious to see and read your sentences. Guys, great job. You rock. You've made it until the end of the lesson. Don't forget to like this video, share this video with a friend who's also learning English, and subscribe to the channel in case you're not subscribed yet. And if you want to keep learning English while having a ton of fun, I really recommend to check out this next lesson. Here it is.
A drink in my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. I'll finally see a summer breeze blow away a winter storm, and find out what happens to solid water when it gets warm. And I can't wait to see what my buddies all think of me.